Because the Firefox web browser is open source, its active community has always made independent custom versions, so-called forks, with specific goals in mind. One of the more recent ones that seems to gain popularity is called LibreWolf, and its primary goal is more privacy, security, and user freedom than basic Firefox. Let's have a quick look at it. LibreWolf is the successor to LibreFox, another Firefox fork that seems to have been abandoned in early 2019. After downloading the software from the releases page, I also had to install Visual C++ to get the browser to start. It's available for Linux, Windows, and macOS, but it looks like you currently have to build the macOS version yourself. The first thing I noticed was the default dark mode. The ad blocker uBlock Origin is also installed out of the box, and any traces of the Pocket add-on are gone. In the settings, Google, Bing, and similar search engines have been removed and replaced by privacy-friendly options. The developers promise fast updates on new Firefox releases while still remaining an independent build. You can therefore install LibreWolf alongside Firefox. Some options have been disabled by the LibreWolf developers, but for some I'm not sure why. Tracking protection can only be changed to custom, do not track cannot be turned off. From what I've heard, enabling do not track often makes a browser more trackable instead of less, since many websites don't honor the setting and many users don't turn it on. The browser apparently is still in a pre-release version on Windows, and it shows in some details. Several buttons didn't work correctly yet. LibreWolf is also trying to implement an extensions firewall to manage network access for installed add-ons. It is in an early stage and currently not very user-friendly because it requires editing different configuration entries and files manually. Regulating network access for extensions is an important feature though. It's not uncommon that popular extensions get bought out and are turned into tracking or spying tools with a sneaky update. DRM compatibility is disabled by default and has to be enabled manually if you're planning on using streaming sites like Netflix or Disney+. The developers of LibreWolf also recommend a list of add-ons to further increase privacy. It was a good idea to not bundle these with the browser automatically, because I've used several of them and some require a lot of work to set up and can break some websites easily. As it turned out in the privacy study of web browsers from a past video, Firefox's privacy by default is only average. I compared the server connections default Firefox made with LibreWolf, which claims minimal background connections, using the tool MITM proxy. Indeed, LibreWolf did not make any connections when idle, which also means no automatic updates or safe browsing features. You need to keep that in mind. Default Firefox makes several connections on startup already. You can probably adjust default Firefox to come very close to the same level of privacy, but LibreWolf can save some initial work. At the moment, it is still a little too early in development for my taste to make it my default browser or recommend it unconditionally, but I'm convinced the project will mature with time.